Hello everyone. Let's have a talk about TRIPS, the features and how it was started, why it was started, and for what reason it was started, and who are the regulatory bodies. TRIPS is regulated by WTO, World Trade Organization, deals with the global rules of trade between nations. The main function of WTO is to ensure that trade flows flawlessly, effectively, democratically. This organization ensures and creates an environment across the nations to follow the rules and regulations at global level, at international level, right? I think that you should know WTO in that way is a system of trade rules. If any question comes, what is WTO? Simply you respond, World Trade Organization. No, that is an abbreviation. Answer is something else. If someone is asking what is abbreviation or the full form of WTO, that time you can reply. But if a person is asking you about what is WTO, it means he is asking definition. And definition starts with its function. The WTO is a global system of trade rules that monitors, that supervises, that ensures trade works and its spreading nature is as per the international rules and regulations. And the third way of defining it is that it does not only monitor, it also settles. Okay, any kind of dispute, industrial dispute between its members, okay, especially of the developing countries, right? Because one of the most important objectives of WTO is to help developing countries, to support developing countries. So you have to understand WTO in these three important terms. That it ensures, what does it ensure? It ensures democratic conditions, flowing of trades across the nations, whether the trade flows smoothly, predictably. The place where it is situated is Geneva, Switzerland, and it was established in 1995. And currently there are 164 members representing 98% of world trade. Budget 197, I'm just copying from the web page. So the current information which I am providing you, especially these quantitative facts, are from the website WTO.org. So, definition of WTO somewhere is having similar definition with TRIPS. So, if you want to understand TRIPS, you have to understand the structure of WTO. You have to understand how WTO is regulated. Who are the regulatory bodies? What does it do? And why it stands for, what it stands for? Only then you will be able to understand the motto behind the agreement. TRIPS monitors the related intellectual property rights, like the rights of writers, rights of performers, rights of producers, okay, broadcasters, okay, possessor or the registered trademarks, geographical indications, design, okay. So all these kinds and forms or the categories of intellectual property are being monitored by TRIPS. What does it monitor? As most of you have told and explained, three important features are there, or three important works are there, you may say. First, it maintains the international standards of protection of copy of IPR. Okay. The agreement sets these standards or these standards by requiring first what? That the substantive obligations of the main conventions of the WIPO. Okay, WIPO is a Paris Convention for Protection of Industrial Property. WIPO stands for World Intellectual Property Organization. World Intellectual Property Organization. So, whatever was established as notions and principles in the convention of the WIPO, right, that becomes the part of standard. Okay, and maintain or force to maintain these conventions or the principles across the countries. All right. So now the question is, why it is named as agreement? Why agreement? Because TRIPS is being followed by the member countries of WTO. And WTO members are, if they follow, they are called TRIPS member countries, and there is no way, other way, to avoid these agreements or these international protection regulations or protection regulatories. No way to avoid. So the relevant provisions are to found in Article 2.1 and 9.1 of the TRIPS agreement, which relate respectively to the Paris Convention, I told you, WIPO, and other conventions. So here you have to remember that in order to maintain these standards, TRIPS agreement follow the principles established in the conventions of Paris, called the Paris Convention for Protection of Industrial Property. Simply, it is called Paris Convention or Paris Convention. This is the reason TRIPS is also called sometimes as, it is also referred to as a Berne and Paris Plus agreement. But internationally, it is well known as TRIPS. Few are also naming as Berne and Paris Plus agreement. Second feature has already been explained by some students is that enforcement is, what is this enforcement? All the members of that of the agreement ensures how they are following and following the international standards of rules and regulations, and in what form they are following it. Right. So they have their own remedies for the enforcement of intellectual property rights. There may be some difference, a little difference, right? But if you see in holistic way or manner, all the countries are following the TRIPS agreement, because only these agreements are there to ensure the product or the trade or the copyright or other IPR are authentic and much demanding throughout the nations or across the nations. So enforcement is another feature, or say it is another function of the TRIPS agreement. The third aspect, dispute settlement. Okay, of course, organizations at international level, wherever it is, are made for this kind of settlement. First, monitoring. Second, whether forcing the law. Okay, and third is as I told you, is the dispute settlement. Whatever the international organization, if you see that they have capacity somewhere, they have power, okay, to settle the disputes across the nations if they exist somewhere because of anything. So the agreement makes disputes between WTO members about the respect of the TRIPS obligations subject to the WTO's dispute settlement process. In addition, the agreement provides for certain basic principles. As I told you that this agreement was influenced by the conventions of Berne and Paris, it has some basic principles such as national and most favored nation treatment and some general rules to ensure the procedural difficulties in acquiring or maintaining IPRs do not nullify the substantive benefits that should flow from the agreement, right? The obligations under the agreement will apply equally to all member countries, but developing countries will have a longer period to face. Special transition arrangements operate in situation where a developing countries does not presently provide product patent protection in the area of pharmaceuticals, right? So the TRIPS agreement is a minimum standards agreement which allows members to provide more extensive protection of intellectual property if they wish, right? Members are left free to determine the appropriate method of implementing the provisions of the agreement within their own legal system and practice. So here convention says this TRIPS agreement says that fine, international level regulations are there being monitored by this TRIPS agreement or WTO, yet the countries and nations are under their law and sovereignty, they can have their own IPR. Here I would like to suggest you all to go through these three important features, or say the functions or the functionaries of TRIPS agreement, and why TRIPS agreement is and how it is connected to WTO and how it is connected to WIPO, right, must be understood by you all. Okay, I will not be discussing the substantive standards of protection because it is very, very much related to law and legal services. Okay, but these basic things, okay, which I have explained so far, may be taken care by the engineering or aspired engineers in future. Now, one thing is discussed is the protection of disclosed information. First, you should understand what undisclosed information is. What is the undisclosed information? Any one of you can tell me what is undisclosed information? It refers to information which is secret and has commercial value because it is secret. Okay, for example, trade secrets are there. Trade secrets is protected in the TRIPS agreement under the framework of discipline of unfair competition. Right. So it's all about the commercial confidential issues of commercial things or industrial things or trade things. Right. So when you talk about protection of undisclosed information, means you are talking about the protection of the confidential rights of the owners of the trademarks at international level. And why? Because of the use that discloses. Okay. So let me explain in detail what protection of undisclosed information is being promoted by TRIPS agreement. The TRIPS agreement requires undisclosed information, trade secrets or know-how, okay, to benefit from protection. According to Article 39.2, I read, the protection must apply to information that is secret, that has commercial value, because it is secret and that has been subject to reasonable steps to keep it secret. Right. Very important. You know, most of you must know that trade goes on secret plannings only, right? The success of a trade is mostly based on confidential issues, right? One must be very much careful of it, and one must be taking it very seriously if he is a part of any firm. That when you are the part of an industry, you have to be careful about what are the fundamentals of the success of that country, success of that particular product that is being protected under laws, right? So that secrets are being monitored and being protected by TRIPS. And in that way, TRIPS forbids the secrets of any company or firm or a trade to be copied by someone else in distorted manner, right? This should be openly explained to the TRIPS, okay, for knowing the singularity of the trade, of the particular trade, and second, for protecting those secrets and save the rights of persons or public or people of that particular trade, right? Take an example from Banarasi Sari. Banarasi Sari is known as Banarasi Sari. Why? Because of its production and because of the way it is being woven, being prepared, and the materials which are being used and the way those materials are being used, right? And how do they do, right? Unless these things are with the TRIPS agreement, right, you are nowhere. In the same way as you design something and you are not letting that design know the government, and before letting know to the government or to the Department of Trademark or Copyright or IPR office, right, you publicly distribute it, and in that way it is no worth. So that will not be the part of copyright act or trademark or say design act. It will not be under that. I have explained it in the last lecture. So undisclosed information must be protected by TRIPS, and it can only be protected when you or the trade persons or people say about that undisclosed information. So without going in depth with the laws and the legal jurisdictions and other legal activities, I have made you to understand the function of WTO and how TRIPS come under WTO and how it monitors the world activity related to the IPR, right? But one thing is there, that it is giving you the nations, it gives nations full liberty to shape and to create their own IPR laws as per the demand of their countries, as per the laws and the sovereignty and the constitution of their countries. Okay, but the monitoring power is there in the WTO, especially on those who are the members of TRIPS agreement.